Hey, sorry, I didn't have any soda, but I got raspberry lemonade.
Oh, that's fun. Thanks.
So, what did I miss?
Everything. The movie's about to end.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the guy just found out that his ex-wife is still alive and that she's dating his brother. Well, dead brother now.
That's disgusting.
Man, you can let go now. The movie's over. You're safe.
Boy, I was not afraid of that movie.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Nobody can scare the Letitia Parker.
Oh, you got jokes. Shut up. Say it like that.
Yeah, it was a good movie, though. I like it.
Huh?
What's wrong? Bad news?
Nothing. It's just sorority business.
Yeah, y'all stay busy with that sorority stuff. Y'all would have to pay me to do that.
I mean, it's a lot of work, but this is what I signed up for, Gil. I mean, it's more to real life than partying.
Well, yeah, I understand that, but I mean, like, what? When do you have time to be Letitia? I mean, every time I see you, it's like, try getting to this or my sorority is that, but it's like you never have time to relax.
I know, but you can't understand unless you're a part of Greek life.
Yeah, I guess you're out of a secret society that regular people don't understand.
Boy, whatever. And I'm curious, you are a well-rounded guy. Why haven't you looked into Greek life?
Well, I'm an individual, and Greeks, I mean, they barely uphold what they stand for. And nowadays, it's more like a popularity contest. No offense.
Not taken. I understand Greek life isn't for everybody. Mm-hmm. And I like the way you think. Nobody has your mindset. It's very attractive.
Sure.
What, did I do anything wrong?
Nah, I just...
What's up?
You're a great girl and everything. You're very attractive and smart, but I don't think this is for you and me. I mean, we have that best friend chemistry, and you remind me of Jasmine.
Oh, Jasmine.
Yeah, I hope this doesn't ruin anything between us.
It's perfectly fine. I mean, it was a mistake on my behalf. We're just friends. But hey, my sorority sisters are trying to get in contact with me, so we're gonna have to finish this next time.
It's cool. Man, bro, thanks for the ride. It would have been real awkward riding with her.
It's cool, man. I thought you and Letitia made a good couple.
Real funny. But nah, we're just friends.
Hey, it be like that sometimes. So how you break it to her?
Well, we were in the middle of kissing. And...
Damn, bro. Really?
What's wrong? She a bad kisser? Wait. Letitia. What's she look like?
Man, Letitia is solid, kid. I don't think I'd have passed up on that.
She that decent?
Yeah, she is. I'm pretty sure you know her.
Letitia. I don't think I know Letitia.
Try again with Letitia. The one from the party.
Oh, you passed up on them long legs? Man, she's sexy as hell. Boy, you tweaked on that one.
Nah, not even. I mean, don't get me wrong, she's very attractive, but we're just friends.
Yeah, whatever, man. You know you wanted to get in between them thighs.
Nah, man, that's not me. A guy who thinks with his dick won't last long.
Right, prolific. Getting into fights and shit, trying to get that ass.
Wait, what?
Whatever, man. Look, I was just trying to stand up for Camille. Her boyfriend is a real clown.
Right, saving, trying to get that ass.
Whatever, dog.
Hey, can y'all turn the radio down right quick?
Yeah, I got you.
Hello? Oh, what's up, big bro? What's going on? You good? Man, because the other night was crazy.
It was crazy, but everything good now, I hope. I'm at the crib right now. I'm about to see if Denise will take me back.
Hey, man, just relax. Look, Denise isn't even trying to hear what you have to say right now anyway. But it should be good, though. Y'all were meant for each other.
Well, bro, I thank you, though, for everything you've been doing for me. I know hearing my sob stories that night is funny as hell. Hey, what's how you done today? No, I was asking because maybe you want to go get some dinner on the strip.
All right, cool. I'm down. Yeah, just don't stand me up like last time, though.
I promise I'm going to be there, bro. All
right, man. Later.
Oh, it's you.
Look, man, I'm sorry about what happened at curbside. I'm just here to see Denise, all right? That's all I want to do.
Denise.
It's okay, Kenny, I called him.
I'll be in the hallway if you need me.
Okay. Thank you for inviting me over. I haven't been able to sleep since the other night at curbside.
Same, darn little.
I'm sorry about what happened with Stacy. It was just one big misunderstanding, man.
Misunderstanding? You slept with my sorority sister. What is there not to understand?
Baby, look, I'm sorry about everything.
DJ, I did not call you over here to talk about that situation. There's been so much going on with me emotionally, and I do not want to relive that night.
I'm deeply sorry about what I put you through. I know if we talk about this, we can make it work. It was just one big misunderstanding.
You made me look like a fool in front of everyone. Can you imagine how that made me feel?
I can't take back what happened. I know me coming over here asking you to be with me is just so hard for you to believe. But maybe if we can just talk about this, we can hopefully get back together.
I didn't call you over here to get back together with you.
I'm sorry about everything. Can you just give me a chance to make this right, baby?
I've been trying to figure out how I'm gonna talk to you about this, but it hasn't been the right time. And I've just had so many emotions going on lately. I love children. Like, I love children, and I'd love to have a family someday, but just not now and not with you. That Stacy situation, it just confirmed that you are not ready to be committed to me or anything else. And I know that you're young, and I know that you have things that you want to do, and I do too. And it's just so much.
What are you trying to say, baby?
DJ, I got an abortion.
What?
I'm sorry, and I really hope that you would forgive me, but I felt that that was right for us, for the baby. I wasn't ready. We weren't ready for a child. Darnell, please say something.
I don't know what to say to you. It's like, you just did something that's gonna affect both of us, based solely off of your opinion. People go through stuff in relationships all of the time. But you just can't keep doing shit if you're getting upset about anything that's going on.
Denise, is everything okay?
Yeah, hon, I'm fine. Look, DJ, I'm sorry. And I just did this because I felt like it was best for both of us. I mean, honestly. Was there going to be another time that this happened? Like, I don't want to be a trophy wife or a babysitter and you on the road in the NBA doing whatever. I got goals too.
You only have to finish. I'm just kind of glad it happened now instead of later on down the road. After all, I can't be like my father.
Chip off the old block.
What?
Can y'all stop, please?
It's cool. I'm sorry about everything I put you through. Hope, after the situation, maybe we could be friends. And the guy that you find to make you happy.
DJ, I'm sorry.
It's alright. It's nice talking to you.
You okay?
Word. You lying. Get the fuck out of here.
What, bro? What?
Man, turn the radio on.
For what?
Bro, turn the radio on.
Aight.
Alright.
You
to take me to a higher place to keep a smile upon my face. Duh, this is crazy. This shit feels like deja vu. Man, I gotta call Camille.
G, I told you, all my hard work paid off.
Your work?
Yes, my work. Oh, so now you got a number one hit. You gonna forget about all the little people, huh?
Hell yeah. Nah, but I appreciate all the support. I ain't out here blowing up alone. I know Camille wouldn't know.
Man, that's cool. She live right around the corner. We go let her know.
Aight.
Have a seat, son. You look like you seen a ghost. You didn't get somebody pregnant, did you?
Yeah.
Look, right now, every so often, player sulks into my office, halfway to tears, talking about how they're not ready for responsibility, how having a child is gonna kill their career. But you just gotta own up to it. Like any mistake you make on the court, blaming it on others is only gonna make it worse.
Coach, I was ready to be a dad. You know, I woke up every morning so enthused about life, man. It's like everything had a new meaning to me.
Had a new meaning?
She aborted it. I don't know if I should be mad at her or I should be mad at myself for everything that I put everybody through. It's like, so much has been happening these past couple of weeks. I had a fling with the tutor, and I really don't even know if basketball is cut out for me anymore. It's like all of the lights cut off in my head, man.
I understand how torn up you are about the abortion. Believe me, it's happened to me, and I learned that you're not the only one hurting. At this point, she's probably hurting worse than you are. I mean, as much as you wanted that responsibility, in reality, you weren't ready for it.
Coach, I was headed to the NBA draft.
And that's how I know you weren't ready. So I know you're still thinking like a boy with a dream. I'm not doubting your talent, but did you ever consider the fact that you might get injured? Or maybe you wouldn't be in this child's life because you were on the road all the time. Maybe you do go somewhere, but you get benched. And God forbid, the draft misses you and you don't get picked. I'm not trying to be a pessimist, but you need to start thinking more. Darnell, life is not a straight path. More like a scenic route, and it takes you places that you never would have expected.
So what's my next step then, Coach?
That's for you to decide. Just like on the court, I may give the orders, but it's up to you to interpret them. I'm just here as a guide.
Coach, you and all of these basketball analogies need to stop.
I'm trying to keep it simple, son. I've seen your grades, and I'm trying not to fry your brain.
That kind of hurt a little bit.
Don't worry, you're tough. Don't worry about women troubles. They'll be around your entire life. Just wait till you get married. That's when the fun starts.
I must admit, man, I do feel a little bad.
Good. It's good.
But I am not getting married, ever. I'll let you know that now, Coach.
Well, you know I'm always here whenever you need me.
Thank you.
I want you to come by in a few days. I've got a friend that works in administration over a sports watch.
I'd definitely be there.
Good.
How is for Jacobs?
Man, you think she home?
Probably. She might be studying. I know she was saying that finals was taking the best of her this week, so.
What's her major?
So I'm like biotech technical, physics, I don't know, something I can't do. Yo, Camille.
She might be in the shower.
You would like that, wouldn't you? Her to be in the shower.
Look. But, wouldn't mind if she answered the door in the towel.
Yeah, I feel it.
Camille! Yeah. No, she didn't leave this door open. Danger, danger. Oh, shit. Bert! Camille! Camille!
Oh, shit.
Hey!
Camille!
Call 911. Camille!
Travis.
Travis did this to you? Fuck! It's gonna be okay, Camille. I got you.
BF, please tell me you got the notes from Mr. Cannon's class.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
How am I supposed to read this? How do you even read this? You have the handwriting of a 3-year-old.
Look, I don't need your help. You need mine. Just remember that.
I'm sorry. You know, I'm just trying to catch up on everything, balance everything out, and then there's Travis.
Hey, all you need is some balance, and then everything else will be fine.
I know, you know, Travis just been acting real strange lately. If it's not one thing, it's another with him.
Yeah. I mean, I still think y'all need some time to separate.
You know what? I think you're right this time.
Yeah.
But yeah, can I ask you something?
Yeah, anything.
What's going on with you and Letitia?
You mean my girlfriend?
I'm sorry about that.
It's all good. And we're just friends. Well, we're friends.
Why do you say that?
Well, she's just been acting really strange, and it's like she wanted something more, but I didn't.
Oh my God! Now it makes sense!
What do you mean?
Letitia used to always talk about you. But I thought it was because she had some type of crush on you. Mm-hmm. She asked me were we together, and I told her we were just friends. Then she always just asked little personal questions about you. So it never made sense, but now it does. When she saw us together, she would give me hell, BF.
Man, so, wait, that's why you being audition that week?
Yeah, I mean, they asked me to tell as few people as possible, so the only person I told was Travis.
True. Well, it's up, man. But we have some studying to do. We have a test coming up, so let's hit the books.
Okay, big kid. Oh, I can't focus. I'm so tense.
You know we got a test coming up.
I know. I just can't focus on school anymore ever since I started pledging.
You know what? Just relax. I got you.
It's good. Put a little more pressure on the side.
How's that?
Better. Hello? Oh my God. Okay, I'm on my way.
What happened?
Look, I gotta go.
What happened?
It's Travis, he's in jail.
For what?
I don't know, I have to go.
All right, you know what? I'm coming with you.
Man, it was only flour I was trying to bake, man.
It wasn't no flour.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Travis Young. Hold on one second. I'm sorry, he's still in holding. You can have a seat in the waiting area, and I'll get to you briefly if he can come out. I'll let you know if it was.
What is he being charged with?
I'm sorry, I can't tell you that right now.
How you doing?
Hi, how are you?
Doing fine. What's the problem?
They're looking for Travis Young.
Travis Young?
Mm-hmm. How you doing? I'm Jasmine Jackson.
Hello, I'm Detective Rule. Did he have anything wrong with his behavior? Domestic violence?
Domestic violence?
Yes, come in the back. So let's talk.
What you think will make him? What's going on?
I don't know. It's been a long night. Just ease your mind, all right?
What's going on?
Yo, Kim?
Oh, what's going on, man?
Hey, what up, man?
Chilling. I'm here with my friend Jasmine. This is Jasmine right here.
Hey, nice to meet you. I'm Matt. Yeah, I'm here with one of my friends as well. She's back there finishing up a statement now.
Oh, man, is everything all right?
Yeah, I hope so. She got into it pretty bad with her boyfriend.
Hi.
Hey,
Camille, that's Akil, and that's Jasmine. You alright?
Yeah, I'm okay. I just don't know what I'm gonna do about Travis.
Yeah.
Travis?
Travis Young, my boyfriend, the one that did this to me.
Hold on, we must be talking about two different Travises. Because Travis is my boyfriend, and he would never do that to a woman.
How dare you? Me and Travis have been dating for 2 years.
Since when?
Down. This is not the time or place.
You're telling me to calm down and she's standing over there lying?
Excuse me.
I can't believe you.
Excuse me. You need to leave. You won't be able to see Travis tonight anyway. You're
get some rest. I'll hit you up later and check up on you.
Matt.
Yeah, what's up?
I'm sorry.
Sorry for what?
For not listening to you. I knew you were right. It's like my heart just wouldn't let me listen. I was forgetting who I was. Such an idiot. I am an idiot.
Yeah, you are. But it's alright. I must apologize too. It really wasn't my place to step in. I should have found a better way to approach it. I know how much love can warp your mind.
Yeah, love. I don't even know what that means anymore. Like, the harder I tried...
Okay, I don't mean to be rude and interrupt your whole spiel. There's no need for you to be so down on love. I mean, you are a beautiful young woman. And that's two qualities that most women would love to have. I mean, they're either ugly or old. But you are also smart and witty and fun and talented. Most girls, they would love to have the qualities that you have. And most guys would kill to be with you. You've got a whole lifetime to find real love. Plus, you're going to be famous anyway. I know your fans will love you.
Famous?
Yeah, our song hit number one today. They were playing it on the radio.
Oh, Matt, that's so great. Did people like it? Did I sound good?
Did people like it? It hit number one. I'm sure a decent amount of people liked it. Now, as far as you sounding good, I don't know. I know I sounded good. All right. You did your thing.
This all feels so surreal. I feel like I was just stressing. Finals! I need to study.
Okay, now, calm down there, girl. You need to get your rest. After everything that happened today, I'm sure they'll give you an extension.
I studied so hard. I'm going to forget all the terms.
Come on now. You're smarter than that. Just get some rest and worry about all that other stuff later.
Yeah. I guess you're right. I really appreciate you being here with me.
Camille, it's no problem. You know I got your back. Get some rest.
Thank you.
No problem.
Hey, ladies.
Sorry I'm late.
Yeah, I miss you.
Nothing, shit. We just getting started.
Okay.
Okay, ladies. Wow, we have great a lot tonight. Mm-hmm. But... let me tell y'all about this theory, though. Okay. So, my uncle taught it to me a long time ago, and I think I should share the knowledge. So, just like men have their bottom bitch theory, where they place the women in their lives where they expect them to be, women should always have a theory of our own. It's called the house theory. And it's a very simple concept, just like everyday house. So, in your house, what are the essentials that you have? You have a floor, four walls, a roof, some furniture, and a door, right? That's how you have to look at the men in your life. So, let's start with the floor. The floor of your house is what you come into and you look at immediately. If the floor of your house is dirty, it doesn't matter how much you clean everything else, your house is dirty. And you have to cover with rugs, you have to do all type of stuff just to keep that floor clean. Whether it's carpet, laminate, wood, whatever the case might be. Your floor is what you pay most attention to. Well, it's your foundation, just like the men in your life. The men in your life, or a man in your life, can be your floor. He's that guy who you always go back to. You're always cleaning up after his messes. You're always caring about him the most, even though he's no good to you, because he's always getting dirty. And you always got to spend a little bit of extra money to cover his raggedy ass over the rug. Okay?
True.
So, that's your floor. Those are the ones we pay the most attention to, but we really shouldn't, because in actuality, all they're good for is to walk all over. Okay? Then you have your four walls. Every house has four walls. It can't stand without it. And that's what every lady should have. Four walls are your compliment men, aka compliment niggas. Mm-hmm. These are the guys that text your phone, make you feel good when you're not having a good day. They always got something cute and nice to say. I know you got a couple compliments. You probably got like seven balls, okay? They text you all the time. They just make you feel good about your day when you're down and when your floor ain't acting right. Every lady should have a compliment guy. And this could be from your best friend to even somebody you consider a bro. Nothing ever serious happened between you and this person, but they're kind of always there just to use for a smile. Then there's the inside of your house, which has all your furniture. Now, your furniture is kind of really essential to who you are as a woman, because it shows what your heart is. It has all of the old lovers, all of your old boyfriends, old boos, anybody who you let into your life spiritually, mentally, or physically is inside of your house, just like your body. And it's really hard to get rid of sometimes. Some of them we keep around for keepsakes, like pieces of furniture, pieces of clothes. And some are just too tight, too worn out, and too smelly. We need to get rid of it. But we won't do that because they made it in, right? And lastly, but not least, is our ceiling, our roof. Now, some of us have a flat ceiling. That means one guy. Some of us have two. Some of us are more blessed than others to have two roofs in their lives. Two roofs in their lives. Usually, the roof in your life is just like in a real house, the last thing you pay attention to. It is a known fact, ladies, by homeowner's guide, that the last thing a home buyer looks at is the roof of their house. Mm-hmm. That's the last thing they take care of. And I'll tell you, my mom, she lived in a house for 10 years. She's just not getting the roof fixed. Usually the roof is what covers us. That's that guy in your life that actually you should be with, but we never look up and pay attention to him because we're so worried about the materialistic things around us, our ground, our walls, our furniture. Mm-hmm. We never really appreciate the fact that we have a covering from someone until it gets leaky and it starts letting things in. That keeps us from the storms, from the heartbreak, all those things we go through. That could be from your best friend to hell, an old lover. You never know, but we never truly appreciate our roofs. So that's the house. Oh. I forgot the door. For us little nasty girls who run the way some of us do, your door is just your freedom money. Never take that person seriously because everybody's hand has been on that handle. Always think of it like that. But that's the house that my uncle taught me, and that's why I'm so successful.
Ooh. That was inspiring.
I'm just saying. And I hope you was listening this whole time with your apartment, condo, Station 8, whatever it is you got going on. I'm just playing, girl. I'm just saying. It's a good theory. I mean, it helped me out, so I don't know. But yeah.
Hey, Stacey, I really need for you to go talk to Denise because I see the hood is way important than any man right now. So please go to the hood.
Okay. I got you. Hey, Denise, can we go talk?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay.
Don't read your message.
Look, Stacey, I owe you an apology.
For what?
For lashing out at you at the party the other day. If what you said was true, and I actually believe that it was, you wouldn't have known that me and Darnell was together. And my problem should have been with him, not you. So, I'm actually pretty sure that it was probably hard for you to tell me this, and I really appreciate your honesty.
Listen.
apology definitely accepted. I'm not gonna lie, I played a part in the situation too. I knew he had a girlfriend, but I honestly did not know it was you. It was an honest mistake. I wouldn't have done it if it was, but I'm really glad we can get past this and move forward because I think we have a special bond. I mean, honestly, out of the entire pledge class, you're the only one that stood out to me. You know why? Because you got a little bit of me inside of you. That's why I made you a pledge daughter. You are outstanding. Brilliant, intelligent, business-minded young lady. I mean, I don't know. I don't want this to keep us from being close. And honestly, we're sisters now, so we shouldn't allow it to affect us like that. He's just a guy. So I accept your apology if you accept mine. Move forward.
I agree.
Okay. Oh, I'm so glad.
Me too.
Ooh, girl, now you guys know why.
Come on.
Yeah, everything's good.
That's good. Well, I gotta get out of here because I gotta go to the library. I gotta pay for the library. You need
a
ride? No, that's okay. I'm alone. I need to clear my head anyway. This Travis stuff got my head going. Okay.
Well, let me know when you get to the library.
Okay. See you later. Bye, ladies.
Bye.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Kim. What's up?
Well, hey, look, I'm still on campus right now. You know, I had to pick some things up from the studio, but hey, maybe we can hook up, you know, and talk about what happened earlier.
Look, Akil, with all the stuff going on with Travis, the sorority, I got this exam, I just can't talk about it right now.
True, well, I'm gonna let you to it. I'm gonna leave you to it.
Wait, Akil, look. After we finish studying, then can we talk about it?
Well, you know, I'm supposed to meet DJ for dinner, but maybe we can all hook up and, you know, get something to eat. Sounds good?
Okay, good. Sounds great. See you in a bit.
All right, cool. Bye.
Hey, sweetheart, let me holler at you for a second.
No, I'm kind of in a rush. I'm fine.
You got time to holler at me for
a second? No, I don't.
Shut up.
No, help!
Shut up. Shut up. Hey, you say something else, this shit over.
How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good time that made us laugh, I'll wake them back. I thought we'd get forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
When we lose something that is precious to us, there's a feeling of sadness. Whether it be a precious object or a treasured friend, we're left with a feeling of emptiness. Close relationships help us feel as if we're not alone in this world. And as we go through life, we amass collections of close friends and treasured objects, and we learn that when you lose something that is precious to you, there is an aloneness that can never be fully filled. Ultimately, the condition of life is one of being alone before God. Akil, rest in peace.
How you been?
Oh, good. Just real busy. How you been?
I've been good, but look, I gotta run right now. Okay.
Wait. I'm holding on to this, hoping I'll run into you. Akil left it at my house.
You know what? I think Akil would have run into you. Class right now. I'm running a little late. Maybe we should have lunch one day.
I really like that, DJ.
You got my number. Don't be afraid to use it, all right?
Okay, take care.
That's a decent camera. Do I shoot videos? I need somebody to do my video.
Nah, I think Pooch will tell a better story.